Hi there. In this video, you're going to learn about map word styles in InDesign. What this style does is it matches the MS Word styles to the styles of InDesign while placing a word text to InDesign. So let's learn how to do it. I've got this document opened here. I'm going to grab the text tool and make a text box covering the whole document within the margins. And before releasing the mouse, hit the right arrow to split the text box into two, as we have two columns here. Next, I'm going to double click inside the first column until the blinking cursor appears and right click and select fill with placeholder text. Once I have the text, let me zoom in a bit and make a heading out of this text and then style my heading. So let's change the font to Trebuchet Bold. Let's also change the font color to red. Now I'm going to select the rest of the text and change the font to Trebuchet Regular and font size to 11 points. Let me add a paragraph style for the body text. So with the text selected, click the small plus button at the bottom of the paragraph styles panel to create a new style and then rename the style Body Text and hit OK. Similarly, select the heading and then click the small plus button at the bottom of the paragraph styles panel and then rename the new style Heading. All I needed was to make these two paragraph styles, so I don't need the text anymore. So click the text boxes and delete them. It's time to place the Word document here. So let's go to File and then Place and locate the document on your computer and ensure to check the Show Import Options box before hitting Open. So this option will not straight away impregnate the cursor with text. It will throw the options window first. On this panel, ensure that Preserve Styles and Formatting from Text and Tables radio button is selected and hit OK. There is a good chance that you'll get an error message like this regarding the missing fonts, but we need to ignore this because we'll anyway map the word styles to the local paragraph styles of InDesign. So let's hit Skip and you shall find the cursor loaded with text now. To fill both the columns together with text, hold Shift and then click at the top left corner of the first column and your text shall be placed into the document. It is highlighted with pink because of the missing fonts, but like I said, don't worry, we got to fix that in no time. If you look closely to the paragraph styles panel, you'll find that the two word styles have also been imported, which we don't need. So click the heading 1 style and click the trash icon setting at the bottom right corner of the paragraph styles panel, and InDesign will send you a notification asking you to replace it with some other style. And I hope you remember we made two styles in the beginning of this lesson. Click the drop down and replace it with heading style and hit OK. And you shall find all the headings taking effect of the local InDesign style we created. Similarly, select the normal style that came from Word and click the trash icon to delete it. From the pop-up notification, replace it with body text style we created and hit OK. And problem solved. You have successfully mapped the word styles to the InDesign styles. There is another way you can do this. So let's hit Command Z on a Mac or Control Z on a PC a few times to undo the last few actions. Let's also trash the two imported styles from Word. You'll get a warning like this, so just hit OK. Go to File and then Place and locate the same text document on your computer. Ensure that the Show Import Options is checked and hit Open. In the Options menu, click the Customize Style Import radio button to activate style mapping option on the right. Click it to reveal another pop-up notification. From here, you can assign local InDesign styles to the MS Word styles. For the normal word style, click the drop down and select body text style. Similarly, for heading 1, select heading. For normal web, select body text once again. And the last option does not really require a replacement, so hit OK. And then hit OK once again to close the options panel. Hold Shift and click the top left corner of the first column and the text will be imported with the InDesign styles applied. Alright guys, that concludes our session and the styles unit as well. So I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.